Hello and welcome to the 18th video of my L4D2 mapping tutorial series. This is a little addendum to the whole series, for those who've simply just wanted to make a survival map rather than a campaign. Well, luckily it's incredibly easy. This tutorial is meant for maps that are purely meant for survival, not maps that support campaign and survival mode in the same map file, otherwise known as multi-game mode support. I'll go over that in particular in the next video. In the map that's prepared exclusively for survival mode, all you need to get it started is an entity capable of sending an input to the director, telling it to start a panic event. This could be a trigger entity, a button, or even the trigger underscore finale entity. For simplicity's sake, I'll use a func underscore button. Make an output on pressed, target the info underscore director entity via the input panic event. Done. The typical item spawning entities, that being weapon underscore spawn and weapon underscore item underscore spawn, won't work when a map is played in survival. We have to use their dedicated spawn entities, like weapon underscore AK-47 underscore spawn and weapon underscore pain underscore pills underscore spawn. When you use these entities, name all of them survival underscore item, which will be relevant later. Valve-made survival maps tend to litter all sorts of items and weapons around the map, so go ahead and do that now. Survival maps need to utilize an info underscore game mode and point underscore template entity to get the weapons to spawn. Make a point underscore template entity and give it a name. In the first template line, type in survival underscore item. Now, make an info underscore game mode entity and open its outputs tab. Make a new output on survival post IO. Target the point template entity via the input for spawn. To summarize what we just did, we set all the items and weapons around the map to be associated with the point template entity. When the map is loaded in survival mode, the point template entity will spawn all the weapons and items. Make an info underscore game underscore event underscore proxy entity next to the button to start the game and open its properties. Give it a name. In the name of event to generate property, type in explained underscore survival underscore radio. Go to flags and check fire automatically when first seen. What this does is automatically generate a hint about using the radio to start the survival game. This is nice if you're using a radio prop like I am. But if you aren't, you should use an EMV underscore instructor underscore hint entity. I covered how to use those in part 11 of this tutorial series. Add an output in the func button that starts the survival game to kill the info game event proxy on pressed. You can load the map in survival by using the console command map, the map's name, followed by survival. Lastly, the Navmesh. I already have one made. Part 4 in this tutorial series goes in depth about making a Navmesh. Check it out if you don't know how to. With your nav mesh fully made, select all of the nav areas in the map with nav underscore select underscore radius 50,000. Mark the nav areas with the attributes battlefield and not underscore clearable. Clear all of the selected areas with nav underscore clear underscore selected underscore set. Select the nav area you want the survivors to spawn in upon loading the map and mark it with the attribute player underscore start. Analyze the nav mesh with nav underscore analyze and save it with nav underscore save. And that's it. Turn the director back on with director underscore start and hit the button to try it out. When you're making the mission file for the map, just set the game mode to survival. In the description is a link to part 16 in this series where I go over making a mission file, if you don't know how. This concludes part 18 in my L4D2 mapping tutorial series. That's it with making a survival exclusive map. If you're watching this and you want to utilize your campaign maps for survival like the default maps do, then watch the next video in this series, where I go over how to accomplish that. Thank you for watching.